Good morning, children. Welcome back to English online class of Sri Gokulam Public School, Guruvayur. How are you all doing, children? Hope you all are feeling good. Yes. How was your experience of first online assessment? I hope now you are feeling more confident of the assessment, right? Yes. So shall we start our today's session? Yes. Okay. So we are discussing the second chapter, nouns from your grammar text. We have covered all the topics in this lesson except one topic is left. Which is that topic? Countable nouns and uncountable nouns. So today we will discuss countable nouns and uncountable nouns. So before moving to the classification of the nouns, let's recall what is a noun or what a noun is. I hope you remember what is a noun, right? So what is a noun? Noun is a naming word. It can be the names of anything in this world. It can be name of a person, name of a place, name of an animal, name of a thing, name of an idea, name of a feeling, etc. For example, name of a person, Gauri, name of a place, Kerala, name of a thing, book, name of an animal, deer, name of an idea or a concept, bravery, courage, etc. Name of a feeling, happiness. All these are the examples of nouns. You have already studied other classification of nouns like common nouns, proper nouns, abstract nouns, concrete nouns, collective nouns, etc. So today we will discuss another type or another classification of nouns, and they are countable nouns and uncountable nouns. Now what is this countable noun and uncountable noun? The name itself suggests the meaning. It's a name of a noun that can be counted. It's the names of those nouns that can be counted. So countable nouns are the nouns that can be counted by using numbers. For example, apple, mango, pen, book, pencil, house, boy, girl, students. So all these are countable nouns. Now what is an uncountable noun? Uncountable nouns are those nouns which cannot be counted, which cannot be counted by using numbers. We can add any other group of words or any other count frames to make it counted. Otherwise, we cannot count uncountable nouns. So what is a countable noun? Nouns that can be counted are called countable nouns. Nouns that cannot be counted are called uncountable nouns. Examples of uncountable nouns are water, ice, bread, butter, cheese, tea, coffee, etc. All these are examples of uncountable nouns. So, in countable nouns, we can make use of both singular and plural forms. Countable nouns have both singular and plural forms. But uncountable nouns doesn't have plural forms. It has only singular form. We have to use uncountable nouns only in singular form. We cannot use the plural forms of uncountable nouns. There are no plural forms. I hope you understood the basic rule of countable and uncountable nouns. So which are the basic rules? Countable nouns can be counted. Uncountable nouns cannot be counted. And countable nouns have both singular and plural forms, whereas uncountable noun doesn't have plural forms. What do you mean by plural forms? Means more than one. Singular means just one. How can we use singular forms for countable nouns? The articles a and an is used with countable nouns in the singular form. You can also use one before the countable nouns to denote the singular form. For example, an apple means just one apple. A house means just one house. You can say a house or one house. So you can add a, and one to denote the number one. You can make use of words or quantifiers like a few, many, several, with countable nouns in plural form. So in singular form you can use a, an, and one. In plural forms you can use a few, many, several, etc. For example, a few books were lying on the floor. So you can add such quantifiers to denote the plural form of countable nouns. Now let's move to the uncountable nouns. Uncountable nouns are those nouns which cannot be counted, and you cannot use a or an before uncountable nouns. For example, you cannot say give me a water. You cannot say, it's a wrong usage. You have to say give me some water. So you can use give me some water. In positive sentences you can make use of the word some, whereas in negative sentences you can make use of the words or the quantifiers like any. There isn't any water in the jug. There isn't any books in my bag. So any is used in negative sentences. Negative sentences means those sentences which have negative words like no, not, never, etc. So you have to say give me some water or give me some milk. You cannot say give me a milk, because water, milk, tea, coffee, all these are uncountable nouns. You cannot use a before this uncountable nouns. And how can you make these uncountable nouns counted? You can also count uncountable nouns. How? Not by using the words a, an, or one, but some count frames like get me a glass of water. When you add the word glass, then you can count it. Get me a glass of water. Get me a spoonful of sugar. Sugar and salt is again uncountable nouns. For example, rice. You cannot say give me a rice. Give me a kilo of rice. That is how you make it counted. That is how you make the uncountable nouns counted, by using such count frames like a kilo, a liter, a spoonful, a glass, a jug, a bottle of. If you make use of such phrases, you can make uncountable nouns also counted. I hope you understood the basic rules of countable and uncountable nouns. Yes? Okay, now let's do the exercises given in your text. Or if you take your grammar textbook, take page number 25, exercise R. Fill in the blanks with the correct words from the box. First one is a dash of flour. It is a sack of flour. A dash of paint. It is a coat of paint. The third one, several dash of furniture. How can you make it counted? Several items of furniture. So furniture, paint, floor is all uncountable nouns. You cannot count furniture, but you can count table, desk, chair, and all. You can ask how many chairs are there in the seminar hall. So you can ask question like how many to the countable nouns, and to uncountable you can ask how much. How much salt do you need? How much sugar do you need? How much milk do you need? You can ask how much to uncountable nouns, and you can ask how many to countable nouns. So try to complete the exercise R. Now let's move to the exercise S. Page number 25 itself, exercise S. You have to underline the common nouns in this dialogue and complete the table. First one, Shashi, what are you stirring? Daisy, I'm stirring the batter for a cake that I'm going to bake for grandma. So here you have to find out the common nouns first. So which are the common nouns? Do you have any common nouns in the first sentence, in the first dialogue? No. So come to the second dialogue said by Daisy. It is batter, cake. Batter and cake is a common nouns. So first you have to underline the common nouns, which then you have to find out the countable and uncountable nouns in it. okay? So batter and cake are the common nouns. So what is batter? Batter, is it a countable or uncountable noun? It is a mixture. We mix all the ingredients together to make a cake, to prepare a cake. So batter, it is a mixture. So batter is a uncountable noun. And what is cake? Cake is a countable noun. That's how you find out the countable and uncountable nouns, and you have to write in the table given below. So try to complete the exercise R, exercise S and exercise T. All these three exercises are very easy. Try to work out all these exercises. Try to solve all these exercises. So I hope you understood today's topic clearly. That's all for today. Let's wind up the session. See you in the next class.